Professors, trustees, and the students of this university. I am deeply grateful for your kind introduction. In our Nepali culture, we regard places of learning as temples of wisdom, and when I am standing here, I feel as though I am standing in one of the grandest temples of all. I extend my heartfelt thanks to you, Madam Provost, for this gracious invitation. Today, I wish to speak about my country Nepal's journey to democracy and economic prosperity, a journey which is full of struggles, sacrifices, and persistent hope. A nation steeped in history, Nepal, nestled in the lap of the majestic Himalayas, is a country that boasts a history as ancient as time itself. The roots of our civilization stretch back over 5 millennia. While our past is steeped in spiritual and cultural treasure, the modern history of Nepal begins in the year 1768, when our ancestors, under the leadership of the then king, Prithvinarayan Shah, unified a series of small, fragmented principalities into a single nation. This was a monumental moment, making the foundation of modern Nepal. It is a coincidence of history that this unification occurred around the same time the United States of America adopted its Declaration of Independence. The two struggles of nationhood were taking place at the same time in human history, yet they were oceans apart geographically. For Nepal, the road to modernity and democracy was not a straight path. For 104 years, under the Rana oligarchy, the people of Nepal endured the tyranny of an authoritarian regime that suppressed their freedoms and stifled their potential. The first dawn of democracy, the year 1951, marked a turning point in Nepal's history. After years of struggle, the Rana oligarchy was overthrown. The dawn of democracy had arrived in Nepal. Yet the utopia of those early years was short-lived. The king soon nipped the democracy in bud, imposing a partyless system of governance known as panchayat system, which was partyless panchayat system. This system, which lasted from 1960 to 1990, prohibited political parties from politics. Despite these setbacks, the flame of democracy was never fully extinguished in Nepal. The people's movements and the triumph of democracy, the flame of democracy, flickered once more in 1990, ignited by a massive popular movement known as the Jana Andolan or People's Movement, which compelled the autocratic monarchy to yield to demand for a democratic constitution. The Constitution of 1990 established Nepal as a constitutional monarchy with a multi-party democratic system and enshrined fundamental rights such as freedom of speech, assembly, and association. But unfortunately, before democracy had taken root, the country plunged into conflict. A decade-long armed violence launched by Maoist resulted in the tragic loss of over 17,000 lives. King seized the power once again on the pretext of insecurity and put the undeclared ban on the political parties. In 2006, again, a wave of democracy swept over the shore of Nepali politics as a mass uprising known as yet another Jana Andolan or People's Movement forced the absolute monarchy to relinquish its power. And it also led to the signing of a comprehensive peace accord in November 2006, ending the Maoist conflict and bringing back the country to peace and democracy. In 2008, for the first time in our history, a constituent assembly was elected. The first very meeting of the constituent assembly took a historic decision to abolish the monarchy, ending the 240-year reign of the Shah dynasty and transforming Nepal from an autocratic kingdom into a democratic republic. This momentous achievement proved the fact that people are mightier than armed violence or autocratic power based on traditional or hereditary. And people are ultimate force to drive the history and shape their own destiny. The promulgation of the Constitution and the road ahead. The Constitution of 2015, written by the elected Constituent Assembly, represents the culmination of Nepali people's 7 decades or more of political struggle and sacrifices. It has provided a stable legal foundation, allowing us to focus on the next phase of our national journey, the pursuit of economic prosperity. Ladies and gentlemen, we see democracy as a political and social system in which every person feels dignified, every person sees boundless potentials, and every person feels safe and secure. My lifelong struggle to freedom has shaped a vision of democracy which I call comprehensive democracy. When I say comprehensive democracy, I envision to cultivate an environment and guarantees equal rights, equal access to opportunities, social justice and security, as well as dignity for all. It aims to elevate women's conscience and advance civilization to a higher realm. Nepal's economic transformation. Now, let me touch upon our journey of economic development. As early as the mid-17th century, Nepal thrived as a vibrant interport between India and China. Trade between these two great nations was routed through Kathmandu, the capital of Nepal, and so much so that Nepal enjoyed the lucrative privilege of minting silver coins for Tibet, a highly profitable enterprise. However, After the establishment of modern Nepal in 1768, the nation was embroiled to continuous wars for expansion and consolidation for several decades, leaving little room to focus on economic development. For much of the 20th century, Nepal's economy was largely feudal and agrarian with widespread poverty. However, over the past few decades, we have made substantial strides in improving the socio-economic conditions of our people. As we look to the future, our national aspiration remains a guiding mantra: prosperous Nepal, happy Nepali. This vision aims to create a society where poverty is eradicated. All are benefited from development, and every individual lives with dignity and hope. Madam Provost, Nepal is not designed for economic backwardness. On the contrary, I hold a profound conviction in Nepal's potential for enduring prosperity, which we can achieve within a relatively short span of time. We are a vibrant democracy with a stock of hard-working young population. Nestled between India and China, both of whom have become economic powerhouses, Nepal is uniquely positioned to make its economy dynamic for accelerated economic growth. I am now leading the government formed by two major political parties in parliament, which have played decisive roles in the journey towards democracy and nation building. Our two parties are committed to providing exemplary governance with impeccable standard of integrity and transparency. Nothing is more paramount to us than to bring prosperity and happiness in the lives of our fellow Nepalis. While being fully aware of a formidable path ahead, I am resolute in my determination to propel Nepal into a realm of sustained economic prosperity. Thank you all. I would be happy to engage in an interactive dialogue. Thank you.